Welcome back, everybody, for another video of Virtual Warfare, text-based roleplay fighting tutorial series. And today's video, I'm going to be sharing a few tactics that I use when I roleplay fight. And I'm going to be sharing these so other people can have ideas to use it too. And so without further ado, let's get on with the training. So it's going to be a few things. It's going to be awareness, reflexes, defense, general attacks, significant attacks, and special attacks. Now, so these are things that I use. So first we're going to begin with awareness. And awareness is very important. Without an awareness, the player is practically blind. And awareness is what helps a player notice their surroundings, such as attacks and elements in the environment, and the natural measurements which space-time manifests in everyday life. Players can have a physical, spiritual, and even a mental awareness, but the capacity of the awareness must be legitimate and within limits. When having a good awareness, players are eligible to react to situations more proficiently by correlating the capacity of their reflexes with the feats of their awareness. Reflexes. Reflexes are essential to using powers, abilities, and other things. With good reflexes, players are able to dish out attacks and defenses more effectively. And with good reflexes, players can dish out actions faster and without thinking. This also allows players to perform particular actions while focusing on an entirely different thought process. When having good reflexes, players are able to react just as fast as the mind can send pain signals or other signals to the brain. Also, the spiritual body of a character can control energy in any analogy that the physical body does. It can pump energy like the heart, control spiritual energy like an adrenaline rush, or even intake energy and filter it out and dispose the rest. Anything the physical body can do through the analogy of reflexes, the spiritual form can also process energy the same way. Defense. Having a good defense is very important because, of course, it is designed to save players and protect players, just like skin, bones, armor, etc. What players don't realize is that with all attacks designed as attempts to do a particular damage, with the right armor, players will be able to block and take damage without being significantly affected by the results initially intended to injure them. Many players do not realize this because many moves and abilities are made to corrode and melt and destroy any armor and sword in any material desired. This is borderline god mode and overpowered, if not explained and done correctly. Because of this, few players are compelled to take damage in fear of the opponent or audience to take it as a means of looking weaker or inexperienced, just because they choose not to completely avoid everything coming their way. Having a good defense is what will save players more than an attack will, and it matters not what armor players have, but when and how players decide to use it. We talked about how awareness and reflexes correlates with each other. So as you can see, reflexes and defenses also follow the same correlation. A player's defense could be physical, mental, or spiritual, but in order to legitimize the content of the logic, players must know the physics on how they actually work. Mastering defense tactics also can help players set up close-range strategies by baiting their opponent into an attack, creating the illusion that they had the upper hand, and then setting them up into a trap. When creating a defense through manifested energy, such as chi, aura, magic, electromagnetics, etc., such power should generate from within a character's main energy source and be able to fluctuate like the energies of the physical body, but in a metaphysical way. Best part is, players can be creative. Players don't have to shape their shields and other defenses in the shape of a bubble, but can create a film around their character's skin that deflects energy or anything of their choosing, but it must be legit. When it comes to the speed of generating a defense, players should want a defense that is strong and durable enough to protect the endangered area in a subconscious or instinctive way. This way, if a player gets caught in a jam, the defense will practically activate and manifest on its own, which in turn could grant the player time to create some space to rethink and attack. General attacks. Attacking is one of the most easiest things to do, but it is also one of the hardest to master. Players can use physical attacks or metaphysical attacks, spiritual and mental. But the most important thing about an attack is not how much force it can deliver, but how much energy or effort one can converse while performing one. Many players do not combine their attacks to strategize a plan or even a surprise attack, but instead combine their attacks and abilities to overpower their opponent. This is not bad, but this should not always be the case. Just how good reflexes can correlate with a good defense, so too can reflexes correlate with attacks. Again, when players are caught in a jam, their character will be able to perform an attack almost subconsciously in a matter of milliseconds. But it all depends on how it is worded and what it is being used for. For scenarios like these, players will want to use a special attack, which I will get to in a little bit. However, when attacking in general, players should create attacks that are strong enough to do damage, yet simple enough to where their character is still fully mobile. This way, players can attack, counter, and dodge at ease because all of their character's attention is not being put into an attack. Here's an example. He charged, channeled, and shot his energy out in a single second, only using a small amount of energy to do this, allowing him to use most of his energy to do something else. As immediately after he projected his energy, he began lightly charging his energy for something greater. Because of this, he was still able to discharge small amounts of energy at will, allowing him to attack and stay agile on his feet. So, even if the opponent throws something at Mach 1, with the idea of players being light on their feet, ready to act, would come into play and enable the player to move more freely, rather than the idea of just sitting there, feet planted, then having to move. Think about it like throwing jabs and staying light on your feet, to move and dodge at any time. This is how general attacks should be. Significant attacks. Significant attacks are attacks designed and prepped to cause significant damage. These attacks should be fully executed only when it's a sure thing that the opponent is strategically incapable of avoiding it and must take significant damage with the possibility of perishing from the lack of defense. Many players give a substantial amount of detail, physics, etc. in their first attack and use it to bank on landing a hit, or for their opponent to overlook the slightest detail to only lead off the exploitation of that scenario. Such method of an attack should not be used to gain the upper hand in battle, nor should it be strategically used as an initial attack to begin a follow-up attack, especially if the player is not sure it will be a clean, direct hit to do significant damage. This is a mistake many players make. For significant attacks, players should be certain that the attack will land. This is where players should emphasize on all the requirements needed for a legitimate attack, even if it's just an illustration. Measurements such as distance, time, effort, speed, etc., even a notation to where the opponent must provide an explanation on how they were able to overcome a particular situation instead of just saying they overcame it because they attempted to do so, should be the top priority when executing this type of attack. Players can even correlate significant attacks along with reflexes, like explained earlier. Virtual Warfare, being fair and equal, notes that such reflex attacks on significant attacks can lead to significant drawbacks, depending on how it is done. Significant attacks equals significant fatigue. It's the only fair way to go. In today's version of roleplay fighting, players cast multiple abilities, shoot energy blasts, and move at Mach 1, all the while raising their internal power as a means of charging up, and never mention any notation regarding the aspect of fatigue and or having to recover from anything. This is very dangerous because it creates the idea that anyone is allowed to write and do anything at any time, as long as they are not exceeded the limitations within the rule set. Also, when significant attacks are performed, players should have an effect linked to it. This is so that the effect can happen while the character focuses on commencing a general attack to distract their opponent. Once this occurs, the opponent will not only have to defend against the effect of the significant attack, but also the attempt from the general attack, creating a scenario where the opponent will have to block both attacks in the very same moment in time. Nowadays, this tactic is rarely seen or done. This is because many players of today write a substantial amount of detail on their first post and hope that one of their abilities or attacks slips in or is overlooked. And once the player realizes that their opponent is actually doing an excellent job defending against the attack, they attempt to nitpick the equations of their defense as a means to find an error to call it illegitimate, even as far as to nitpick things that should have been addressed in the very beginning of the match. This is why the majority of battles either end with players attempting to disqualify one another or attempting to have the better argument. Not even a minute worth of screen time is accomplished by either player within the roleplay. In the ancient world, roughly 10 years ago in the art of roleplay fighting, about 20 turns or more were done in each battle. This is because the writing was short and to the point and based on strategy, not power and measurements attempting to overpower their opponent and outright their foe. Virtual warfare is the structure of ancient world, but in the detail of new world. This confuses many players when attempting to understand this concept. This is because players of today see today's version of roleplay fighting as the most legitimate form, and virtual warfare as a copy, when in studying the history of roleplay fighting, the key elements and methods for ancient world and virtual warfare are the same, and the key elements and methods for virtual warfare and new world are the same. This is because today's version of roleplay fighting is a copy of virtual warfare, not the other way around. As players begin to know the history of roleplay fighting, they begin to see the key elements which makes a world or style what it is. As players will be able to see the core principles and changes for themselves. But I digress to special attacks. Special attacks are similarly done like significant attacks. However, special attacks are done by exerting the full potential of a character's energy into one special attack. When this is done, the opponent cannot just simply block or use one of their gnawing abilities or substances that eat and absorbs all kinds of energy in one instantaneous effect. But by the way, that's kind of overpowered. When a player uses all or most of their character's effort to attack, the opponent must also use all or most of their effort to keep up with their player. If not, the attempt will be god mode, being virtually OP, because the level of effort was not matched. For example, the opponent and I are wrestling with energy beams against one another. In order for me to overcome the opponent, I have to exert more energy, which I would then lose but recover later. My opponent just can't say, raises my energy and shoots back like a walk in the park, because it clearly shows that I used most of my exertion and my opponent barely used any. Because of this, characters become OP and psychologically think of their own character being stronger than their opponent. Thus, they will be inclined to make the opponent inferior by making it seem like every ability and move is done effortlessly. And if the opponent expresses a substantial amount of effort, the player would think that just because the character is moving effortlessly and the other is not, the one exerting more effort is seen to be weaker, as if they are using more energy to keep up with someone who is moving effortlessly. This is a false understanding, because in reality, both characters are potentially equal by being under the same rule set and limitations. So, virtually, whoever exerts the most power is the one who will come out on top, not seem weaker because they are exerting more power. The character is giving it all that they have to become stronger than their opponent, not look weaker than them. But that pretty much wraps up the end of this video. It's really not much. Everybody has their own tactics, but this is my tactics that I use. Everybody's welcome to use them. Hopefully, some credit will come my way. Well, if it don't, well, I'm expecting it because this is what YouTube videos are for. You know, people always take content and display it as their own or use it as their own. And that's just how life is. And, it is what it is. But thanks, everybody, for supporting Virtual Warfare. Stay tuned for more videos. Stay tuned for more. Stay tuned for more videos. I mean, that's all I'm posting. Stay tuned for more videos. I'll see everybody in the future. Deuces.